कृष्णवर्णं त्रिशाकृष्णं सांगोपांगास्त्रपार्षदं यज्ञैः संकीर्तनप्रायैर्यजन्ति सुमेधसः अन्तःकृष्णं बहिर्गौरं दर्शिताङ्गादिवैभवम् कलौ संकीर्तनाद्यै स्मः कृष्ण चैतन्यमाश्रिता जयतां मथुरा भूमौ श्रील रूप सनातनौ यौ विलेकयतस्तत्त्वं ज्ञापकौ पुस्तिकामिमां कोऽपि तद्बान्धवो भट्टो दक्षिणद्विजवंशजः विविच्य वेलिकग्रन्थं लिखिताद्वृद्धवैष्णवैः तस्याद्यं ग्रन्थनालेकं क्रान्तव्युत्क्रान्तखण्डितं पर्यालोच्यातपर्यायं कृत्वा लिखति जीवकः यः श्रीकृष्णपादाम्भोज भजनैकाभिलाषवान् तेनैव दृश्यतामेतद् अन्यस्मै शपथोऽर्पितः श्रीमद्भागवतं श्रीमन्मन्त्रदेशिकमीश्वरं श्रीमद्भागवतार्थानां सन्दर्भं कर्तुमाश्रये अतनत्वा मन्त्रगुरून् गुरून् भागवतार्थदान् श्रीभागवत सन्दर्भं सन्दर्भं वश्मि लेखितुं यस्य ब्रह्मेति संज्ञां क्वचिदपि निगमेयाति चिन्मात्रसत्ता व्यंशो यस्यांशकैस्वैर्विभवति वशयन्नेव मायां पुमांश्च एकं यस्यैव रूपं विलसति परमव्योम्नि नारायणाख्यम् स श्रीकृष्णो विधत्तां स्वयमिह भगवान् प्रेम तत्पादभाजाम्
How many students? 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 14, 16, 16 and here. Okay, someone is missing. Baki dono? Theek hai. To 14 hai, to mane 10 log, 9. अच्छा 10 आर एब्सेंट ओके आई विल चेक टुमारो अटेंडेंस एंड विल सेंड द नोटिस दे डोंट वांट टू कम ओके दे कैन कंफर्म विल स्टार्ट व्हाट वी आर डिस्कसिंग यस्टरडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग So what can be the, what is the criteria for non defective shabda. So what is the first point? Everyone should get the wisdom scholarship, or other way wisdom also you can take. Maybe that word is having some problem, then you can take wisdom. Wisdom is best word actually. Yes, all the kinds of wisdom can come from this. Next. No, that is third point. Yeah, I'd give scholarship to everyone, all the kinds of. So yeah. Next. This that means whatever the knowledge established by Sabda Pramana will purify Pratyaksha and other Pramanas. That means the knowledge which is attained through the Pratyaksha and others, that knowledge can be purified by this knowledge. Okay, next. So it's self-accomplished. That means it is beginningless. So see, it becomes self-sufficient because it is beginningless. Next. Root for the... Yeah. It is a root for the all traditions. And next. That's all. Only five. Five only you said, no? Is anadi. No. Sorry. Okay, five, not six. Okay, five. Six. Yes. So what about the Vedas? So Vedas are also, who is going to satisfy this criteria? Only Vedas. So if you have any book like that or anything, so you can show, which is, if all of you have, okay, you are having.
No, can I, there's an objection.
What is the objection?
So how do we establish these 5 points for Vedas?
Yeah, these 5 points, because Vedas are saying. Because Vedas are saying.
Tomorrow,
you can check, actually. You can check these things. So we know the Vedic knowledge is complete. And Vedas are self-sufficient. Because only the one point is, if you want to prove Vedas with this criteria, Vedas, who is going to say this? So then, even that criteria is also set by Veda itself. You are understanding? This criteria is given by Veda itself. So that means he is a king, actually. He is an emperor. And he is a king. And who is going to prove the king, actually? So...
There's a implicit understanding here that everybody would accept that the Vedas are a source of knowledge, but that may have been the case 1,000 years ago, but that's not the case anymore.
Also, we have seen the Mula, actually what Jiva Goswami is saying. Pramana, so tasat sani na pramanani, after that, iti anadi siddha sarva purusha paramparasu. That means it is accepted, actually, these Vedas. If you go to the Mula, you can see one more extra point Jiva Goswami is saying. So it is not that I am saying or you are saying. It's accepted by the... So all the authentic Pramanas, Paramparas. Means, it is accepted by all Paramparas which are famous from time with no beginning. Anadi Siddha Sarva Purusha Paramparas. That means it is accepted by all these paramparas. So generally we do the triangle check, actually, generally sometimes. That means guru, shastra and the sadhu, actually. And fundamental point is Vedas are self-illuminating. That's why Vedas itself are the self-illuminating being, that nobody is going to establish that. If you say someone is going to establish Vedas, then he is superior. It's like a chain, actually. Then who is going to approve? Then who is going to approve? Then who is going to approve? Like that, you'll be going to the infinite loop. It will lead to the infinite loop.
That means someone is going to approve Vedas. Then who is going to approve that person? And some X. And who is going to approve that person? That means it's a sudura dhavati. That means you have to run like that. So infinite, that means loop. So that is not any good logic actually. If you do any programming and if it is stuck in any infinite loop, is it good programming? In the C language also we know. So if you do any time programming, so if it is stuck in the any infinite loop, can we say it's a good program? Of course you write everything nicely, but one place it is stuck in and it's keep on iterating in the same loop. Then is it good logic? No. Similarly, any logic person, you should give the explanation which is free from the this kind of defect. Yes? Any logic, any logician establish anything that should be free from the this kind of defect. That explanation should not lead to the infinite loop. That is a dosha. You're understanding? So that means one time you one day one place you have to stop. You have to stop. Something is self-sufficient. Yes or no? You have to accept someone as self-sufficient. There is no other mean actually. If you go on like this searching, so that means who is the cause for that? You will never reach to the end. Then what is the purpose of life? Just struggling in that kind of thing. So that's why one place you should stop, that is the Veda. That's why we say self-illuminating. Yes or no? Yeah.
Prabhu, somebody may say that there are two options for me. One option is that I am accepting, one may accept Vedas as axiom. Axiom means there is self-evident truth. There is no need to, they can't be established. Like, you know, it's an axiom that one equal to one is an axiom. You know, you can't be proven. It is it's taken. Similarly, we accept it as that the Vedas have these six qualities, and we take it as an axiom because they can't be proven, as you said. If you start to prove it, then the pramana which is used to proven it becomes higher. So that's it. But another person may say, hey, I'm taking Vedas as a product of human intelligence, and I feel that that's also, you know, also defective. And I trust my senses more than the senses of the ancient people. So I feel I have better sense of knowledge than the ancient knowledge. And in that sense, they may reject, and actually they reject the Vedas in that manner. That's something that's the modern opinion. In that sense.
So you are forgetting our previous discussion. We already defeated that all options. What we said, pratyaksha, anumana, whatever the shabda, aitihya, sambhava, ityadi, of any human being is dependent to the non-defective shabda. That is already done.
That's an assumption that there exists a non-defective shabda.
Oh, so non-defective shabda is we already proving na, that is this Vedas. So that is not the question of the assumption actually. Assumption means that means already this pratyakshadis are defeated by that assumed. Those are all pratyakshadis are defeated by the assumed non-defective shabda. Now we proved that non-defective shabda is having this six criteria, and that is Veda. So what is the point of the once again? These are all coming.
Because we never proved that the non-defective shabda is the Vedas, and you said that can't be proven. So the point is that if somebody doesn't have a natural faith in the Vedas as being non-defective, then we can't move any forward. We are stuck with that. We don't have anything to establish non-defective shabda.
Come again.
How do you establish? Like, suppose if I say that I don't accept Vedas as non-defective. Okay. I feel they're made by some other humans in the past.
But you see, there is no choice. Already we clearly established any pratyaksha pramana, adi pramanas are defective.
Yep.
Then he cannot say that I don't believe. And I don't believe means, so someone is arguing that still that means he doesn't have any choice, but still he is supporting his own logic. That means his anumana pramana. So then what he said, kutarka karkasha mudaha. So what we can do? So who can remove their path of leading to the illusion and the false knowledge? So that means he simply boldly said this. Why he said this word, this strong word? So whoever is reading this, they are getting this because it's bad logic only. If whoever is going against to this, he's simply using the bad logic. That is not like infinite loop. There's so many other loops it will be entering into that. It's simply improper knowledge, actually. Improper tarka, that is. He himself is saying, Jiva Goswami himself is saying, kutarka karkasha mudaha. They are foolish. Yeah, anyway, we'll go forward. So, Nacha Ishwara Vihitam Vaidikadi Shastram Amatam. So now, one more point is coming. Nacha Ishwara Vihitam Vaidikadi Shastram Amatam. So, Ishwara Vihitam means it is given by the Lord. Like Dhanvantari gave the medicine, that's Ayurveda. So, someone may say, it is not Apaurushaya, but it is given by the Lord. So, how can I take this as the authentic Pramana? Or can we accept the authority of the Ayurveda or not? Of course, it is not Apaurushaya. So, then how can you, or otherwise, not only that, some other literatures which are written by some Vaidushas, which are but written according to the Vedas. Can we accept those can we accept their authority or not? That is the point. He is saying that we can accept. We should accept that. So what is that? Nacha Ishwara Vihitam Vaidikadi Shastram Amatam. The scriptures which are given by the Lord, so are not authentic. Like that you cannot say. Are not authentic, you cannot say. Pramana abhavad itaravat
yati iti chet paresham tad anugatatvadeva shastratva vyavaharah.
So these scriptures are these literature which is written by the Ishwara or some other Vaidushas. So those are not having any proof. So that's why I say those are all not authentic. Then some Purupakshi may say like this. Then we are saying, no, you cannot say like that. They are also authentic only because they all are following the Vedas. That's why they are also authentic. That means, what is the conclusion? Any literature which is in line with the Vedic conclusions, so that is also authentic only. That's the point.
Nacha buddhasya api ishwaratve sati tadvakyam cha pramanam syad iti vacham.
Oh, okay. Ishwara, that means Dhanvantri, he gave the Ayurveda, but it is in line with the Vedas, that's why it is authentic. So similarly, like the Dhanvantara, so Dhanvantri, so like the Buddha also is Ishwara. He also gave the Shunyavadam. So that is also authentic. This is the point someone is raising. So anything is done by the Ishwara, so which is in the in line of the Vedas, so it is authentic. Then some, by hearing this immediately, some opponent is standing. And immediately saying that this everyone is in the sleeping mode actually. Struggling actually. 1, 2, 3, 4, even Ashrayakur Prabhu is also struggling. 4 and this Sarvesh Prabhu is struggling. He is just you are active. So Mitra Shrestha is struggling. He just about to close his eyes. Huh? No? You are okay? He's already in the trance. No. Ujjwal, it's okay? Sleeping. Because you are all having heavy, hectic schedule. Na? That's Sanskrit has the power of this. Yes. Very sweet and yes. That's better to give the picture only. If I keep on explaining, then no one will get.
Then I will do little hard work then.
What is the today's discussion where we started? Any work? Any literature in line with Vedas is is authentic. Example. Then one three. Hi. By Dhanvantri. So that means Ishwara Vihitam. That means this is done by the Ishwara. Vedas are done by the Ishwara? Vedas are done by the Ishwara? No, Vedas are not by. You should not say it's a Ishwara. It's not done by anyone actually. Like Jiva is done by the Ishwara? Jiva is created by the Ishwara, can you say like that? Anadi. Similarly, Vedas also. Maya is created by the Ishwara? No, they are also anadi. But these are all energy of the Lord only. They are not independent from the Lord. But they are not done by the Lord, and also they are not independent from the Lord. Because how they have connection? These are all energy, and he is the energetic. Like that, we have the relation. Similarly, Vedas are also. So, okay. Now, what is the difference between this Vishwara Vihitam? Ayurveda, I am not saying exactly. So, here I am just taking Ayurveda, but Ayurveda is already is Veda. You can take the some work which is done by the Ishwara. Example, what he said here, Nacha Ishwara Vihitam Vaidika Adi Shastram. Some Vaidik Shastra. So, instead of taking some work, example work, some work, some work done by, some work in relation to medicine, done by Lord Dhanvantri. I cannot say exactly Ayurveda, then it will become confusion. So, okay, some work in relation with the medicine done by the Lord, and these are all authentic only because they are following the Vedas. So, okay, now here we are bringing one point. What is the point? So, Ishwara, which is done by the Ishwara, so that is authentic. That kind of understanding someone took. And based upon that, Purapakshi is asking, opponent. What is that? Buddha. Buddha is also Lord. So, whatever philosophy is given by him is also authentic. Philosophy given by Buddha is authentic. By him. Is authentic. Someone may raise this objection. So then, what is the answer? So that means we have to follow Buddhism. That means Buddha said that there is no Ishwara. We don't believe in the Vedas. So these are the teachings of the Buddha. So that means we should not believe in the Vedas. So this kind of, because you are only saying, na? Anything done by the Ishwara is the authentic. So then Buddha also did this. So then this Nirishwarvadam he established. So that means we should accept the Buddha philosophy. Huh? Why not? You are only saying, no, whatever is done by the Ishwara is authentic. Huh? What Prabhu? Ashray Gauram Prabhu. Oh, you read that, then you don't tell. No, what? No, that is not correct actually. That I will tell anyway. You want to say differently? Prabhu, you are able to see? Then you come Prabhu this side. You can sit here otherwise. Yeah. But at least you can come. No? Buddha's philosophy is not in line with the Vedas. What is the criteria we took? So what we established, anything done by the Vishura in line with the Vedas is only authentic, we said. Yes? But Purapakshi is raising question. So Buddha did this philosophy and that we should accept. He is saying that proposal. That means every time when I ask the question, what I asked, so the philosophy done by the Buddha also we should accept, because anything done by the Ishvara is proper. In that way, I raise the question. So that means Purupakshi will not understand everything. That means in the previous statement, what you said? In the previous statement, we established that anything done by the Ishvara and also in line with the Vedas, that is the authentic. And when Purupakshi raised the question, he skipped half. What is that? In line with the Vedas, he skipped. And he asked what? So Buddha is also Ishvara, whatever he did, that is authentic. Then what you should say? It should be in line also. In line with the Vedas.
What does it mean by saying it is not in line with?
What does it mean?
Veda, the knowledge is in line with Vedas. This statement, yeah, I wanted to understand more about this.
Yes, that will come. So, nacha buddhasya api ishwaratve sati tad vakyam cha pramanam syat iti vachyam. Yena shastrena tasya ishwaratvam manyamahe tenaiva tasya daitya mohana shastrakaritvena uktatvat. Because, so who is saying Buddha is Ishvara? Vedas are saying. Yes? How will you accept Buddha as Ishvara? Because Vedas are saying. That's why you accept Buddha as Ishvara. And the same Vedas are saying, you should not follow his statements. You should not follow his statements. You should not follow his statements because what is the reason? He made those statements to bewilder the demons. Understood? It is mentioned in the Vedas. This is also mentioned in the Vedas. The same Vedas, what they are saying? They are saying, you should not follow his words, his philosophy. Because he made that philosophy to bewilder demons. Okay? That means you cannot say that simply Buddha is Ishvara, so whatever you said, authentic. Because who is saying Buddha as Ishvara? Veda. And that Veda is what it is saying. So whatever he made those statements, those are all should not be followed. Those statements should not be followed because these statements are meant for the bewildering the demons. So that's why anything made by the Ishvara, so is authentic, that is not correct, and it should be following the Vedas. Vedas has to approve that also. Understanding? Otherwise, sometimes, so even great personalities, they come and they say so many things, and those things may be having some different purpose. Like the Shankaracharya, he is also incarnation of Lord Shiva. Shiva is the Mahavaishnava. So whatever he said is right. Like that we should take? No, you cannot take like that. If you take like that, so that means whatever you said, then it will be wrong actually. Because the purpose is different. So that's why they should be in line with the Vedas. That means in line means what? They should follow the conclusions of Vedas. What is the conclusion? Vasudeva para Veda, Vasudeva paramakaha. What Vedas? What is the conclusion of all the Vedas? Nigama kalpa taror galitam phalam sukha mukha adamrta dravasavi. So nigama kalpa taror galitam phalam. This is Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam is the conclusion of the Vedas. So that should be that whatever the teachings given by them should be in line with the Vedas. This is the meaning of in line with the Vedas. So that's why anything, whatever we establish, we discuss, that should be according to the Vedas. You can imagine the form of the Lord. Any form can you imagine and worship? So Lord is having infinite forms, so that I will imagine my own form. So something, some different shape, and I will, this shape I will keep and I will worship this. So yeah, Sruti Vata Neetam. That means it should be in line with the scriptures, Vedas. You cannot manufacture your own name, mantra. So instead of Hare Krishna, you may manufacture something. Something, some words. No. So next, yesterday, Nama Sankirtan Prabhu was asking one question. So whatever we get the Shabda Gnanam, Shabda Gnanam or Shabda Bodha. That means, Shabda Bodha means getting knowledge from words. So you are hearing na Hare Krishna or something, whatever you are hearing, that is what, that is a Shabda Gnanam, that Shabda Gnanam. So what I am teaching and you are hearing and you are getting the Shabda Gnanam. But here we are hearing through what? Through the ears. We are hearing through the ears. That means ears are involved in this process. And ears is a pratyaksha pramanam. And we already said pratyaksha pramanam and the sabda pramanam both contradict. Then your shabda gnanam is dependent on pratyaksha. So that's why pratyaksha, it is, since it is depending on the pratyaksha, that's why it is not authentic. What is a purifying? What did you mean? Purifying means, it's purify the senses. Purifying means what? While receiving the knowledge from the Vedas, your pratyaksha is involved or not? Your ears are involved or not? Your ears are involved or not? Yeah. How you are hearing any word? You are hearing through the ears. Ears are what? Is a pratyaksha pramana. That means you are getting the knowledge is dependent on pratyaksha or not. Yes. So that's why your shabda is dependent on pratyaksha. That's why it is not authentic. Nama Sankirtan Prabhu is there or not? Okay.
We read in the Pratyaksha case, Pratyaksha can be supported by Shabda Gyan. There's nothing wrong about it.
Huh?
Pratyaksha can be supported by Shabda Gyan.
Pratyaksha? Okay. But Pratyaksha is contradicting the Shabda also. I'm taking that point.
Pratyaksha is what?
Pratyaksha is sometimes contradict with the... That means Shabda is overruling, means Pratyaksha is saying something different and that's why it is overruling. That means there is a contradiction.
But here we are just talking about hearing the Shastra. There's nothing contradictory there.
Hearing Shastra means you are hearing through the ears and ears are involved. And ears means Pratyaksha Pramanam. That is, Pratyaksha Pramanam is already, we established it is a difference. It is all having sometimes difference with the Shabda. So that's why, so your Shabda is not authentic.
But I'm hearing the Shabda Pramana, which is not defective.
Yeah. So this is the objection. This is only objection. I am just making you to understand objection. It's not the conclusion. till now, Prabhuji said, till now, Shabda is superior. Now he is saying, Shabda is dependent on Pratyaksha and Shabda is not authentic. What is this? This is not conclusion. So please, this is a way of explanation. That's it. So in the Shabda Pramana, how the knowledge is generated, first you see. The process is what? First, words are there. Words. These words you hear. So, words you have in your mind. So, by the process of what? Hearing. Hearing, okay? What is that? Hearing. So, hearing. After hearing, you will get the words. Then after that, words are, meanings of these words are recalled. Meanings of words are recalled. And after recalling the words, sketches. Then after that, recalling that, then you will be interpreting that. That means connections. Connections. Anvaya, otherwise you say Anvaya. Anvaya of meanings will be done. Then after that, finally, you will get the knowledge. Hear what? Hearing means what? Production of the words. Production of words. Production of the words. So the production of the words means production of these words. Hare Krishna, if I say, those words are produced in your ears. Yes? Through the, those are produced. That is the meaning of production. My meaning. Production of the words. This is done by the what? Hearing. That means this is done by the process of hearing. So here, who are involved in this? Production of the words, who are involved? Ears are involved. Ears are involved. Okay, now these ears are the pratyaksha. So pratyaksha pramanam. So that means what? Hearing of the words means what? Someone produced the words Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Those words are produced, and those words, that sound vibration, those words are coming to your ear. That's a, what is that drum? What is that drum? That is eardrum. They are coming and they're touching. This is what? Indriya Vishaya Sannikarsha is happening or not? Then after that, you are getting the words to you. These are the words from the speaker. Speaker produced these words. And coming and touching the listener. This is the listener. This is the listener's eardrum. This is. They're coming and touching. Then words are produced for him. Yes? Production of the words. This is only production of the words. It is not the production of the knowledge. Yes? This whole process is production of the knowledge. This is production of the knowledge. And this is the production of the words. This production of, this is what? This shabda, sound vibration is coming and touching the eardrum. And this is not the indriya, the sannikarsha is there. Then this is known as pratyaksha pramanam. Yes or no? Pratyaksha pramanam is involved in the production of the words or not? Yes. Pratyaksha pramanam is involved on the production of words are depending on the pratyaksha pramanam. This is clear. Now, Puru Pakshi is raising question. Who is saying now? Now we are discussing from the Vachaspati Mishra's commentary on the Advaita Bhashya. So Shankaracharya wrote the Bhashya on the Vedanta Sutras. Okay, that is known as Sharirika Bhashya. On that Bhashya, so Vachaspati Mishra also wrote commentary. It's a commentary on the commentary. He wrote the Bhashya on the Shankara Bhashya. So that is the Sharirika Bhashya. So he wrote the commentary on the Sharirika Bhashya. So this Bhashya name is Bhamati Tika. Yeah. So Vachaspati Mishra, whatever he wrote, this is known as Bhamati Tika. Bhamati was his wife actually. Vachaspati Mishra's wife. So he gave her wife's name. So Vachaspati Mishra was deeply involved. That means after marriage, so he wrote the commentary on many, many things actually. In the Nyaya Sutras also he wrote on the Sharirika Bhashya, he wrote, and so many books, so much literature, even in the many, all the darshanas he touched. He is such a very highly scholar person. But he was keep on writing, and he didn't care about his wife. And after many years, he realized, I didn't care her and I didn't do anything for her. So finally he did. So he gave the name for his tika, this tika, on her name. He produced this, published this tika on her name. So that is some little story. But come to here. So Vachaspati Mishra is discussing, that means Jiva Goswami kept the whole text from the Vachaspati Mishra's tika. Jiva Goswami, as it is, he brought out the in the Mula, actually, in the Sarvasamvadini, Atra Vachaspatischa Eva Maha. Even Vachaspati also said like this. So from here till the Paurva Paryam Baliyastvam Tatra Nama Pratiyate Anyonya Nirapekshanam Yatra Janma Vidhiyam Yatra Janma Dhyam Bhavet. Till that. This is completely Vachaspati Mishra's commentary we are taking. In that commentary, we are going to discuss what is happening. Okay, in that commentary, Purapakshi is saying, not Vachaspati Mishra is a Purapakshi here. He wrote the commentary. In that commentary, Purapakshi is there. He is saying what? See, your production of the knowledge, that means in the Shabda Bodha, production of the knowledge is also known as Shabda Bodha. Adi Shabda Gnanam. This Shabda Gnanam is dependent on Pratyaksha Pramanam, Jeshta Pramanam. Jeshta means, so before happening the Shabda Gnanam, so Pratyaksha Gnanam is there, Pratyaksha Pramanam is involved or not. So that's why it is Jeshta. Jeshta. That means it is first. It is Jeshta. So since it is Jeshta to the Shabda, Pratyaksha is the Jeshta to the Shabda. So that's why what he is saying, Purapakshi, what he is saying. So Nacha, Jeshta Pramana Pratyaksha Virodat Amnayasyaiva Tad Apekshasya Apramanyam Upacharitardatvamva Iti Yuktam. He is saying, so Pratyaksha Pramana is a Jeshta and it is following that. That means Shabda Pramanam is dependent on Pratyaksha Pramanam. So that's why, and also Shabda Pramanam and Pratyaksha Pramanam both are contradict. Yes or no? Many cases we saw. Many places there is a difference, opinion difference was there. But anyway, who is winner? So Shabda is a winner. But But now I am not taking. That means this Purapakshi is not considering that. He didn't accept the Shabda as supreme. So Purapakshi means he is always putting finger on you. So he is not accepting the authority of the Shabda, but simply saying that. So Shabda is also dependent on Pratyaksha. And both are contradict each other. So that's why. So example also you see. We see whatever we see that is correct. Pratyaksha means what? Whatever we see that is. Pratyaksha Pramana always says whatever you see that is correct. But Shabda comes and it says, no, 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 that's not correct. That means there is a contradiction. So for saying contradiction, there are so many examples. Shabda and the, so Pratyaksha are the contradict. That is there any problem for you to accept this? No, no, no. Now come to these two points. One is Shabda is dependent on Pratyaksha. That is one. And also Shabda and Pratyaksha both are contradict. Because of these two reasons, he is saying, so Shabda Pramana is not authentic. And since it is following the Pratyaksha Pramana, that's why, so you cannot take the as it is meanings of those words. Those words should be following the meanings of the Shabda should be following the Pratyaksha. Because it is dependent. Okay? Like this, Purapakshi raised objection. Objection is clear? Now answer. Feeling difficulty to understand? No, no. You should not feel difficult. Samanand Gaur Prabhu, going inside. So now we are saying, no. What are the two reasons they are giving? Purapakshi is giving to say Shabda is not authentic. Pratyaksha is a jesta. Pratyaksha and the Shabda are the contradict. These two reasons they say. Now we are defeating that. We are attacking on that. On those points. We are saying here. Asya apaurusheyataya nirasta samasta dosha sankasya bodhakataya cha swataha siddha pramana bhavasya sarvakarya swakarya pramitau para anapekshatvat. We are saying, hey, my dear Purapakshi opponent, you are wrong. It is not appropriate what you are saying. Because, first of all, you see, these Shabda, these words are what? Apaurusheya. Apaurusheya. That means they have non-human origin. These words are the Apaurusheya. So that's why, since it is Apaurusheya, that means these words are free from the four defects. So since there is no free from the four defects, that's why there is no. So defect in these words. There are no defects in these words. That means a nirasta samasta dosha shankasya. Next, what we are saying? Next, we are saying these words are free from the defects. Words are free from the defects. Next, swataha siddha. In the production of the knowledge, that means you see from here, words are there and knowledge is produced. So this words are producing knowledge independently. These words are producing knowledge independently. There is no involvement of Pratyaksha. What we are saying, these words are produced, and these words are apaurusheya, and they are independent. They are independent in production of the knowledge. That means words are giving the meaning. In this process, Pratyaksha is involved. No Pratyaksha is involved. So we are taking the words, and after that we are recalling the meanings of those words, and we are getting the anvaya, and finally we are getting the knowledge. In this process, pratyaksha is not involved. So that's why you cannot say, you cannot say, so sabda pramana is not authentic. Shabda pramana is not authentic. You cannot say. One may have doubt. Prabhu, Purva Pakshi, what it is raising and what kind of answer you are giving? One may get this kind of Purva Pakshi's question and your answer is not matching. It is looking like that. Yes or no? Purva Pakshi is raising what? So pratyaksha pramana is a jeshta to the shabda, and that's why it is dependent on the pratyaksha, and that's why it is not authentic, since it's depending on others. So now what is given, we are saying that it is apaurusheya and it is self-illuminating actually. So that means they don't dependent on any others. That means words are free from the defects, and these words produce knowledge. Yes, independently. So these are all authentic only, we are saying. Here the what is the answer? So answer this part we are going to give answer. That means pratyaksha is being a jeshta. So pratyaksha is being a jeshta, so that's why shabda is dependent on that. That point we will answer in the coming discussion. Here we are just answering this. What he is saying, what he is concluding, Purva Pakshi is concluding that shabda is not authentic. That much we are taking actually in the first step. Shabda is not authentic, you cannot say. What is the reason? It is apaurusheya and it is swataha siddha pramana bhavaha. That means it is self-illuminating. It doesn't depend on any other pramana to produce the knowledge. So that's why you cannot say authentic. That much we answered. The conclusion we answered, but not the complete thing. Complete objection we didn't answer. Okay? So because acharyas, they write one line, but it is having the so much inside. Inside is quite difficult actually explaining also. You are getting now what we are going. We did that. What Purva Pakshi concluded, your pratyaksha is not authentic. Sorry, your shabda is not authentic. He concluded that. So we are saying our shabda is authentic because it is apaurusheya. That words are apaurusheya, they are not free, they are free from the defects, and it is also swataha siddha pramana. So acting independently and producing the knowledge. Okay. Next step. Nirastha samasta dosha shankasya bodhakatayacha swataha siddha pramana bhavasya swakarya pramitau para anapekshatvat. Next, pramitau anapekshatvepi utpattau pratyakshapekshatvat tad virodad anutpatti lakshanam asya apramanyam iti chet na उत्पादक प्रतिद्वंदित्वाभावात् अप्रतिद्वंदित्वात्. ओके नाउ पूर्व पक्षी इज सेइंग ओके यस आई एक्सेप्ट. नाउ पूर्व पक्षी इज सेइंग लाइक दिस. हाँ ओके आई एक्सेप्ट इन द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द नॉलेज shabda is not dependent on anyone. Okay, but in the production of the words pratyaksha is independent. It is dependent on the pratyaksha. Okay, that point that Purva Pakshi is coming his own point. He's coming and he's saying, okay, shabda in production of knowledge Shabda is independent. Is independent. So, okay, this okay, he's accepting this. Purapakshi is saying okay for that. But next, what he's raising, second point, he's accepting this. Second point, he's saying that. So, but in production of words, it is dependent on, it is means Shabda is dependent on Pratyaksha, what speech? It's dependent on Pratyaksha, okay? So that's why, but Pratyaksha is defective. But Pratyaksha is defective. So since Pratyaksha is defective, that means whatever words are produced are also defective. Words are defective. That means we cannot produce words at any time properly. And that means you don't have any Shabda Pramana at all. You cannot have the Shabda Pramana. Total, he blasted now. You are understanding what he is saying? Purapakshi, what is saying? You are understanding or not? Okay. I will ask on the online one student. Who will ask? Whom? Nam Sankirtan Prabhu. So what is the last point?
The last point was that the Purapakshi, he accepted that the production of knowledge, Shabda is independent, but still Shabda is not independent of the Pratyaksha.
In what way?
And the Pratyaksha comes first, that we hear the
production
words.
Production of the words, you should say. Mm-hmm. In the production of the words, Pratyaksha is involved. Yes. So production of the word. So that's why production of the words, Pratyaksha is involved. Pratyaksha is defective. That's why. So you cannot have such a position. That means, so defectless words, and you cannot have the defectless. So Shabda Pramana also. Now answer we are giving. Nah, you cannot say like that. Purapakshi, this is a Purapakshi. No, my dear Purapakshi. No, not allowed. Okay. No, wait. No, it's not correct. You are not correct. Because Utpadaka Apratidvandvitvat means in the production of the words, there is no contradiction between the Pratyaksha and Shabda. In the production of the words, so Shabda is not rival, or the Pratyaksha is not rival towards Shabda, or the Shabda is not rival to the Pratyaksha. Okay? There is no Pratibandhita. Pratidvandhitva means rival. Competition. There is no competition. Just, I said Hare Krishna. You heard Hare Krishna or not? That means Pratyaksha and Shabda will be the rivals in the case of what? In the case of the establishing absolute truth. Okay? In the tatvika gnanam, they rival to each other. Okay? Example is, they say that this what you eat, sleep, whatever you have, that is only fact. And this body is permanent. And you just enjoy anything from the body and be happy. This is Pratyaksha. But Shabda is saying that you are not body, you are soul. Okay. In the tatvika gnanam, they have the rivalry, not in the common knowledge. Okay. Next. Nahi agama gnanam. No objection, actually. Because you will be, whatever objection, possible doubts, will be clarified by the author himself. Because authors are such a intelligent, any common man or any super intelligent man, whatever doubts he get, so they are considering that and writing. So maximum we can try to understand. Yeah. objection is overruled. So nahi agama gnanam, nahi agama gnanam sam vyavaharikam pratyakshasya pramanyam upahanti. Nahi agama gnanam. Agama gnanam means this. Agama gnanam means here, especially here, what? Apaurusheya. Apaurusheya words. Okay. These apaurusheya words. That means scriptural knowledge. Agama gnanam means what? We took here what kind of words? Apaurusheya words. Means what? Those are all the scriptural words. Vedic. Agama means here what you should take? Vedic knowledge. Agama gnanam means Vedic knowledge. So Vedic knowledge, that means Shabda Bodha, that means Shabda gnanam means Vedic knowledge here. Because Vedic words only free from the defects, because they are coming from the Apaurusheya source. They are coming from the Apaurusheya source. That's why Vedic words are imperfect. Are they perfect? Vedic words are perfect, and that's why they produce the perfect knowledge. So that's why here Shabda Bodha, Shabda Gnana means Vedic knowledge. This Vedic knowledge and Pratyaksha Gnanam, both are contradict in the Tattva, in the related to Tattva, not in the case of common knowledge. That is the point here he said. Vedic knowledge in the notes, second time I send a redone, that you should open. What is, where is the place, in which place? Yeah. So no, that is not so. Shabda is not rival of Pratyaksha in production of words. Scriptural knowledge doesn't destroy the validity of Pratyaksha Pramana related to objects belonging to day-to-day life. Scripture knowledge means Vedic knowledge. Vedic knowledge, you are all opening and seeing. Ujjwal, where is yours? उनको ओपन करके दी थी, है आपके पास फाइल? वेर एवरीवन इज फॉलोइंग? क्या नाम है उनका? स्वर्णकांति, बोलिए, यू रीड इट लाइन, कंप्लीट लाइन, वेर आई एम रीडिंग. Mike, this Baba Mike.
Send it.
Why you are taking from there? You are not seeing in your laptop?
This is another.
Another, okay.
Rather, Shabda destroys the validity of Avaidusha Pratyaksha in matter relating to Tattva. That is, Pratyaksha's authority is matters of Tattva.
Where you are studying?
Two.
Why? Okay.
So what should be only D.
That means you are not following. Where I am reading, that I am checking actually.
D2.
everyone has to try to follow at least what is happening in the class. You should know. Even if you are not knowing what is happening in the class, so then what is the need of, what is the point of sitting? And you are following, Prabhu? You read the line what I read. What I read. Ah, okay, yes. Yes. Many times in the last batch, I saw some students, entire course, they were not able to follow where the text is going on, actually. That kind of problem they had. Even they are feeling difficulty in the following text. Where I am reading that itself, they are not able to identify. That should not happen in this batch. In online students, everyone is following or not? So, okay. So it's very difficult, actually, if you don't follow the words. So now come, refutation. So now we are seeing, what we are saying, this is not so, Shabda is not rival of Pratyaksha in production of words. Scriptural knowledge, that means Vedic knowledge, doesn't destroy the validity of Pratyaksha Pramana related to the objects belonging to day-to-day life. Samvavaharikebhyaha means the objects related to the day-to-day life. So that means, okay, one way you can say now, what we want to say, whatever pratyaksha you use to get the words, that pratyaksha is that not rival, and that is normal pratyaksha. So that's why you cannot say, so pratyaksha, sabda pramanam is defective. That is a whole discussion that is happening. So come to the next repetition of sabda doesn't occur. Next, if scriptural knowledge defeats day-to-day validity of pratyaksha, then sabda will not have any means of reception through senses and without reception. Shabda doesn't have any existence or any benefit. Nacha tat tasyotpadakam. Rather, Shabda destroys the validity of Pratyaksha in matters relating to Tattva. So that Pratyaksha's authority in matter of Tattva is not the producer of scriptural knowledge. Okay, I will just wait. Purapakshi, what it is saying? He is saying that in production of knowledge, Shabda is independent. Okay, I accept. But in the production of the words, it is dependent. So that's why produced words are defective, and Shabda Pramana is also completely defective. That is Purapakshi said. Then we said no. We said no, it's not correct. Because Pratyaksha and Shabda are not Virodha. They are not Virodha in the case of production of words. In the case of production of words, they don't have any rivalry. So that we said. Then after that, they don't have any rivalry in the case of production of the words. So when they will be having the rivalry and when they are not having, that we should clarify now. When both are rival to each other, that we have to clarify. Pratyaksha and Shabda. When they are rivalry and when they are not rivalry. That he said here, in this he is saying that Nahi Agamagnanam Samvyavaharikam Pratyakshasya Pramanyam Upahanti. That means here in this, you can see in this board. So Shabda is not rival of pratyaksha in production of words. Next, this one. Scriptural knowledge doesn't destroy the validity of pratyaksha pramana. That means samvyavaharikam pramanam means validity of pratyaksha pramana related to objects belonging to day-to-day life. This is known as samvyavaharika pramanam of pratyaksha. This is not destroyed. So that means scriptural knowledge will not destroy the authority or the validity or the authority of pratyaksha pramana related to the objects belonging to day-to-day life. Okay? Why? Whereby due to not having a mean of production, so reception of shabda doesn't occur. So then if you consider other way, that means shabda and pratyaksha are rivalry in the production of the words also, if you take, then what will happen? Then you will not at all be having any knowledge, no shabda gnana. Okay, so that means yena karana bhavat na bhavetu, but apitu tatvikam, but shabda and pratyaksha, they are rival in the case of what? In the case of tattva. So next, if the scriptural knowledge defeats day-to-day validity of pratyaksha, then shabda will not have any means of reception through senses, and without reception, shabda doesn't have any existence or any benefit. This is the yena karana bhavat na bhavet. This is the point actually. Okay? If you consider shabda and pratyaksha rivalry in the production of the words also, if you say, then what? Then there is no existence of the shabda pramana itself. Okay, clear? That means in the D point, we are seeing the one. That is done. Now next, two. Rather, shabda destroys the validity of pratyaksha in matters related to the tattva. So that means pratyaksha's authority in the matters of tattva is not the producer of the scriptural knowledge. Okay. When they both fight, pratyaksha and the shabda, in the case of the tattva, that means in the case of the higher things, that means in the case of the supreme truth, they both fight. So next, nacha tattasyotpadakam, and one more point, pratyaksha's authority in matters of tattva is not the producer of the scriptural knowledge. Like this. That means, see, this is the pratyaksha. Pratyaksha is having the two parts. Pratyaksha telling about the tattva. Pratyaksha telling about the day-to-day objects. Samviharika. We are dividing into two parts. Pratyaksha is divided into like this. So what we are saying, this part, day-to-day objects, this pratyaksha is not, there is no contradiction with this pratyaksha with the shabda. And this is the, that means this pratyaksha which is telling about the tattva, this is defeated by the shabda. Shabda defeats this pratyaksha. Okay? Shabda defeats this pratyaksha. That means if pratyaksha start telling about the tattva, then immediately shabda will come. Oh, you are who? Who are you to tell? You stop. You cannot tell. Okay? Now, if you say, This is samvyavaharika pratyaksham. If this is also is rivalry, if you accept, then shabda is not at all accepted, and then there is no shabda pramana at all. No knowledge will be gained. So that's why we should accept this. That means there is no rivalry in the case of pratyaksha, in the case of day-to-day objects. Okay, we'll go later. Let us go this. So now, this case, there is rivalry is there. Now, this pratyaksha, that means the authority, or otherwise pratyaksha related to the tattva, that is not needed to produce the shabdagnan. This is not needed. The authority of the pratyaksha in the case of tattva is not necessary to produce the shabdagnan. Are you getting? That's the point here we said. So that means, wait, because if you go out the flow, then unnecessarily it will stop the flow. Wait, we can discuss later. So pratyaksha's authority in the matter of tattva is not producer of scriptural knowledge. This is the point I am said. This is pratyaksha's authority in tattva is not the producer of shabdagnana, scriptural knowledge. Getting? So then, and we are saying, atatika pramane bhyopi samvyavaharike bhya tattvagnanotpatti darshanat. Now next, the tattika pramanyam of pratyaksha, which is prohibited by agama, is not the producer of agama. Okay, next, because tattva can be received in, so this just example, that is means it is just explanation of this statement only. This is the statement, okay? That means pratyaksha's authority in matter of tattva is not producer of scriptural knowledge. That is, we are explaining the tattika pramanyam of pratyaksha, which is prohibited by agama, is not the producer of agama. That means scriptural knowledge. The same point. This is same. This is same with this. Okay. Next, come to here. Because tattva can be received even from the atatvika pramanas related to the day-to-day life. Example is, so for instance, short and long sounds on being manifested as words are the cause of producing tattva. Words like, okay, tattva. No? What I said? Pratyaksha pramana is two parts, this and this. That means pratyaksha, which is telling about the day-to-day objects, pratyaksha, which is telling about the tattva. So, okay, this pratyaksha is not necessary for the production of the shabda gnanam, that is a scriptural knowledge. Which is enough? This is atatvika. This is tattva. This pratyaksha is telling about the tattva. And this is what? This pratyaksha is what? Is telling about the atatvika. Day-to-day objects means atatvika. So even this pratyaksha is sufficient to produce the shabdagnana, means producing the words. Okay, this pratyaksha is enough. This pratyaksha is enough to produce the words. And from that words, anyway, we'll be getting the knowledge. Okay? Atatvika pratyaksha. Atatvika. Example is, now you are hearing the words from my mouth. That means, hraswa, dirgha, and this anything, if Sanskrit also, if you take hraswa, dirgha, these are all there. These words you are hearing and you are getting the knowledge. Yes? In this case, there is no problem. Yatha varne hraswa dirghatvadayaha anya dharmaha api samaropitaha tattva pratipatti hetavaha. So now you are hearing, that means, so nigama kalpataror galitam phalam sukamukadamrita drava samyutam, like this, like janmadya seto anvaya ditartaschar dveshabhignaswarat. So like this, you are hearing, these are all simply Atatvika, that means these are all produced, these are all you are hearing. These words, that means Hraswa, Dirga, Pluta, this, that, that means Akara, Ikara, Ukara. These words you are so hearing, so through the Pratyaksha, that is just simple Pratyaksha, which is telling about the day-to-day objects. That Pratyaksha is just generating the words to you, and those words are producing the knowledge. So in this, there is no confusion actually. There is even the Pratyaksha Pramana, overall it is defective, but in this case, it is not having any problem actually. It can produce words. Yes? Pratyaksha Pramana is defective like that. You cannot say overall, that means everything is defective and finish. No. We are just now, that's why analyzing clearly. Pratyaksha means in what case it is defective, where it is defective, where it is defeated by the Shabda. So that part is different. And Shabda, which is telling about the simple objects, that is normal Pratyaksha. So that normal Pratyaksha is enough for us for production of the words. So we don't have any confusion. Example you see here, one more. Words like Naga and Naga, meaning elephant and tree, don't create confusion in common people. Naga and Naga. So like example. So that means you cannot say, that means in the normal Pratyaksha, there is no illusion actually. There is no illusion. Example is Nagaha and Nagaha. So in this, like these two looks similar. So are you getting any illusion due to Pratyaksha in these two case, in these two words? Are you getting any illusion? No, no. What is the meaning of Nagaha? Elephant. And what is the meaning of Nagaha? Tree. So even a common man will not get illusion by hearing these two words. Yes or no? It's not, he doesn't become a great scholar to differentiate these two. Any common man will simply understand Nagaha means elephant and Nagaha means tree. So that's why what it is proving. So Pratyaksha Pramanam related to the hearing the words is not having any problem. So it will not be creating any illusion. Okay? Okay. This here we'll stop and we'll continue later. Yeah. Mike, that's right.
You said the word Janmadiyasya and Nigamantarpagal. Yeah. So, but they are related to Tatvik, right, Prabhuji?
No. Those Tatvik Pratyaksha is not necessary, na? Simple hearing only, na? Simple words, Janmadiyasya, that means normal Pratyaksha is sufficient to production of the words or not. Production of the words is different from the getting the knowledge from the words is different. That's why I said two parts. You people hear back this lecture once again. Please hear. Otherwise, it will not go inside. It's not so easy also actually. Yeah. Please hear back and try to analyze, try to understand, and try to feel and see the Sanskrit and also notes, whatever is given. Try to understand those lines. And if you have any difficulty, please come to me. You can write the questions. Okay, any doubt in this? Yes. Nam Sankirtan Prabhu.
Hare Krishna. You know, I was thinking about this, the whole point, but I think my case is more related to production of knowledge, not the production of words.
Yeah.
I just thought about the verse about Atashri Krishna Madhi Nabhavedra Imindriha and Sevana Mukhi Jivado Swayama Vasparachada. I was just thinking that Sevana Mukhi is the key in production of correct understanding or anvaya. After we hear the words, which is the common shabda, common pratyaksha, and then the second part of understanding what these words mean and how they connect together, and to generate this inner, I would say, revelation.
Understanding of words, we already, that is not the discussion actually. So that is shabda itself is self-eliminating, and those words, whoever is knowing the meanings of those words, they will get the knowledge. Whoever is knowing those meanings of those words, their proper meanings, then they will get. So that is
like, you know this famous verse about following the Mahajana Yanagatasa Panta. So someone can say Mahajana means many people go this way, so that's why we follow. But some people say Mahajana means great people follow, that's why we follow. So it's the same words, but we can give them different meaning. So does it make sense?
So you are saying the one word can have the different meanings?
Yeah, so Mahajana means many people, or Mahajana means great person.
okay. Yeah. So yeah, that is another point actually. That is not the here today's discussion. We are not discussing about the what are the different how to deal the various meanings of the one word. That is not the today's discussion. That we'll discuss later.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? We are now just sticking to our discussion to the production of the words. In the production of the words, because of the pratyaksha pramana, are we getting any, that means, illusion in that or not? That there is no illusion.
That's clear, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. That much is only necessary to understand. Yes. Yeah. Vikas Prabhu? Online, on site? Anyone have any question?
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Yes. Quickly, Prabhu, you have to short the question actually. You should not keep on explaining. It should be precise and direct. Yeah.
So the question is, Prabhu, many times in the classes, you are asking questions to us, online people. Like, for example, are we following you? Are we seeing the screen?
Yeah.
And I'm struggling to understand how we can interact to you when you ask us.
Yeah. So you can tell that our Atul Gopal Prabhu is always with you. So he's on the, he's watching everything. And if anything is there, immediately he tell to me.
But Prabhu, you ask straight questions for his immediate response. And there will be, chat, there's a time delay if you know, we all chat and write and, you know, attention also goes.
Okay. You can come here actually.
Yeah. Other quick, I think that will be blessing, you know, you have to request Radha Krishna to get me there.
Especially you can come.
So the other point, Prabhu, the quick point which I wanted to ask you is there a possibility, Prabhu, when you are reading the PDF, that sometimes you share the screen?
Yes.
But a lot of times we miss that. So that helps us to, you know, to be with you on that sheet.
Yeah. Okay.
Thanks, Prabhu.
Yeah. Namaste, Prabhu. Break started.
Prabhuji, when you say tattvik jnan, can we understand tattvik jnan as conclusive knowledge? Why I'm saying is, because while discussing pratyaksha praman, anuman praman, etc., we have also taken many examples which are like a common day-to-day example. So for example, there is a snow in Himalaya. So that is looks like common. So when you say tattvik jnan, we cannot understand by pratyaksha, that means the conclusive knowledge, not the alaukik knowledge only.
The tattvik means it is a conclusive knowledge. Yes, there's about the tattva.
Because snow in the mountain, it is not just information, but it becomes conclusion. So it is conclusive knowledge.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. On site. Yes. Chaitanya Jeevan.
As you told in the lecture that these Vedas are self-evident.
Yes.
So when we see that to establish the supremacy of Krishna, we take shelter of Vedas.
Yes.
Because without the evidence of Vedas, we cannot prove the supremacy of Krishna.
Yes.
So it means that we can think that to establish the supremacy of Krishna, we need the help of Vedas. Means that Vedas are proving the supremacy of Krishna.
Yes.
So Vedas are superior than Krishna.
Vedas are, no. Vedas are also energy of the Lord, and energy is not different from the energetic. So that's why there is no, it's a problem for the self-illuminating. Vedas are the energy of the Lord. Energy is not different from the energetic. So that means Vedas are non-different from the Lord. And that means if Vedas are illuminated by the Lord is illuminated by Vedas, or Vedas are illuminated by the Lord, there is no contradiction. Okay, thank you very much, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. That's why Achintya Bheda Bheda is powerful. Anywhere you can attack. Any question can be answered. It's the biggest weapon, actually. Huh? Ramchandra Prabhu, yes?
Yeah, Prabhu, Hare Krishna, can you hear me?
Yes, Prabhu, tell me.
Yeah, Prabhu, like this, thank you very much for sending this this document where this Anucheda 2, where you mentioned all those points there. But sometimes like when you speak Sanskrit, like it's I become off, I need to go to another document and track it over there and come back. Is it possible, like you can put the Sanskrit line also here so that we can just see one document and then we can follow?
Prabhu. Last document was like that only, but today some changes I made. So quickly I send this, but otherwise I thought to keep everything together. If you see Anucheda number 2, which I sent earlier, so that was having the both together, Sanskrit and English.
Okay, Prabhu. Okay.
Okay, I will try, Prabhu. I will try to do.
Yeah, that will be really help so that we can actually follow, because Sanskrit like suddenly become off. I need to go to do a second document and find it out where you're reading, and then I come here, then just to make one meaning from the Sanskrit, it's become very easy for us to understand.
Yes.
Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you very much.
What is the Vikas Prabhu asking? Vivek Prabhu. Vikas or Vivek? Vikas. What is your question, Prabhu, in the right chart you are writing?
Yeah, Prabhu, the question I asked is that Atman is also energy of the Lord.
Yeah.
So it should be self-revealing. Why it needs any other support?
Yeah. So it is showing itself, actually. When we do the Nishkama Karma Yoga, so when our Antakarana is purified, so then we'll be getting the knowledge about the self. Swatma Vishayaka Gnanam. We are going to get this. But the point is, Atma is self-illuminating, but it is not having that property completely. That means what you say, it is dependent on the Lord. So Lord didn't give that feature to this fully. Atma reveals itself. That means someone is dwelling in their own self. It's possible, actually. But it is not completely. But in the Vedas, that feature is there. That means, of course, everything is energy of the Lord. But the Lord is having the full independence to give the features to that energy. How many features he should give, how many he should not give, that he himself is having that role, that capacity, actually. So he made Vedas to reveal himself. But he didn't give that kind of feature to the Atma. Of course, it is also energy.
So is it okay to say, Prabhu, Atma is not independent?
Is not independent, yes. Even the Vedas also not independent. Lord gave that's why they are self-illuminating.
Okay.
Prabhu. And that is also not separate from the Lord. So that's why they are still self-sufficiency is also there, and also Lord's supremacy is also there. Everything is internal to him.
Okay, Prabhu. I will try to think over it.
Yes. Hare Krishna.